Adobe InDesign is the king of DTP, but is it the king of design? This is a very interesting video we're going to get in today, and we're going to show you some facts about InDesign, Adobe, Canva, Affinity Publisher, Microsoft Publisher, QuarkXPress, and a lot more. So let's go check it out. As they say, data doesn't lie, but it sure does tell a tale. So the way we're going to do this is over on Google Trends. Many of you may have heard of this. Some of you may have not. Many people use Google Trends in various industries. For instance, in the financial sector, in trading, they'll use it, for instance, to look up, okay, on the search term Bitcoin, how popular is it? And you switch from Netherlands to worldwide, and you switch to past 12 months, and you see what's going on. It's been going down a bit, just like the price, right? Now, if we compare that to, say, gold search term, well, look at that. Gold has been going up while Bitcoin has been going down. Once again, look at the price. Gold had a correction here the last couple days. Look at the dip down. So very, very interesting, right? Now we go back to Google Trends here, and now let's start at, well, some would say the bottom of the barrel, but it probably has the most design users out there of traditional DTP or design tools for your desktop, and that would be Microsoft Publisher. We're going to do search term because we want to keep it broad. Once again, we switch from Netherlands to worldwide. We switch to let's switch to past 5 years, and then we can see. Now, what do we see that's very interesting? We see a spike in Microsoft Publisher. Are they getting that many more users? Well, the news came out right around in this time frame that Microsoft is discontinuing Publisher support in October of 2026, next year. By the way, check out Markzware's MarkzPortal.markzware.com. We can convert Microsoft Publisher files right into many other file formats. Most of them you're going to see here later in this video. Side note, let's call it the sponsor of this video. Right, so Publisher has had a steady sort of volume, and then lately it's kicked up a lot because of the discontinuation of Publisher. People are searching for alternatives, right? Now, if we cruise down, we can see where it's most popular. And you can see some interesting stats, right? Now we're going to go over here to compare. We're going to hit compare. And now we're going to add in Affinity Publisher search term. Canva purchased Affinity right around here. I think it was March 2024, and that would be right around here. And you see since then, since that period, they've had a steady incline getting up to the Publisher levels, which they were at 2020 not even close to, right? So you see how Affinity, with their Affinity suite, but Affinity Publisher is one of the products in that suite. And you see how popular that has been getting, and see that it's definitely have an upward trend, where Microsoft Publisher has had an upward trend, but that was for a different reason. We know what that reason is. So very interesting, right? Well, now let's just, for the heck of it, let's just throw QuarkXPress in there. I'm just curious. Search term. And you see that's way down here, and you see it's actually going down over time. And if you go back even further, you'll see how popular QuarkXPress was. It was once the king of design, the king of DTP. It's now down here, really at the bottom of the barrel. But it's still a great product. They have some very interesting new features coming out in their latest version. And yeah, it's still a viable desktop publishing program. Matter of fact, some swear it's the best typography, you know, controls out in the market. So now we have that there. But let's add now, of course, the current king. And we won't call it Adobe InDesign, we'll say InDesign search term. And look at that. It dwarfs all the other DDP applications out there. There's some strange dips, and it says an improvement or data collection was applied. So this might have been some anomalies, because you can see they have a very steady path. And over the last 5 years, it's actually gone up. So, which is very, very interesting, right? And if we go down below, we can see, so if you sort by InDesign, you'll see the biggest ones are Taiwan is the biggest percentage-wise, huh? Then you have Denmark, 96% InDesign. Then you have the Netherlands, 96. Belgium, probably the same, 96. And then Norway, also 96. So very, very interesting, right? You can see the top users of these products. And if we switch to, for instance, Affinity Publisher, we can see Czech Republic is 7% Affinity, 90% InDesign. Germany, not surprising, not only 91% InDesign. A lot of the DAC countries, Deutschland, Austria, Switzerland, Germany, Austria, Switzerland, have been very anti-subscription. So you can see those numbers here. Poland, similar, Jamaica, and Trinidad and Tobago. So very, very interesting. If you look at just the United States, you see InDesign is 92%, and Affinity Publisher only 2%. There's a lot of growth there for the Affinity team, without a doubt. QuarkXPress is really, really down there in every country now, less than 1%. Even 0%. All right, now let's add another search term. Let's add in the newcomer, Canva. Wow, look at that. That is something. Not only is it a steady upward trend, it leaves InDesign in the dust, which was, as you saw, the top of the traditional DTP softwares. InDesign was the king. But Canva is the undisputed, what's above a king? The emperor? I mean, it's just amazing. And what's even more amazing is, look at it. It's reaching all-time new highs right now. Last I heard, they have 250 million monthly active users. 250 million. Okay, let's scroll down. And let's, Canva, it's just, I see a purple, and that's the color they got here, which is coincidental. That's like closer to their branding colors, isn't it? So we see Tanzania, huge Canva user, 92%. Zambia, all these African countries just loving the Canva, which makes sense, because Canva's whole initial drive, and still to this day, is democratizing design for non-designers and for those on budgets. You can use Canva for free for a lot of really cool stuff. Canva Pro, you get a lot more options, but the free version works, right? So it's really the freemium model, so to speak, is really amazing with Canva. So this is just incredible. Now, if you go look at like the US, you'll see 94% Canva, InDesign 6% in the comparison wise. Netherlands, 88% Canva, InDesign 12. France, InDesign 4%, Canva 96%. Morocco, 99% Canva, right? Another Northern African country. Spain, 99% Canva, 1% InDesign. And I can attest here from Markzware, those numbers, they add up. It's Italy. Now, I'll be surprised in Italy if we don't see a little more, a little more InDesign use, 3%, right? Northern Italy has a lot of very active professional, DTP operations, fashion, and a lot of other industry there. 97% Canva still. It's just amazing. Canva, even in Russia. 12% InDesign, 87% Canva. It's just amazing. India, Australia. Wow, only 95% Canva, 5%. they got to pump it up there in their home country, right? New Zealand. So you get the idea here. This is just some really amazing numbers, and you can scroll down and you can see all the different related queries, right? So, and then of course you got Canva. Interesting. CapCut is the next big. CapCut's my new secret, but I guess it's not so secret. People are, you know, that is just an amazing video editor. I really love it. But Canva's doing good with video editing as well. And you see some other interesting, of course, AI image generator. Canva's big on the AI. So isn't that just amazing? So when you start digging into the related queries, you see that a lot of people are also searching for Affinity Publisher. If you look at the top related queries for Affinity Publisher itself, you see the top ones are Affinity space InDesign. People looking, how do they get Affinity into InDesign? This is a top concern. People who switch to Affinity need to also share with InDesign users. Once again, check out Markzware, markzware.com. We have a lot of great solutions for interchanging DTP InDesign file formats from one type to another. MarkzPortal.markzware.com is where you can get the actual online conversions, and we have desktop versions of the same. We're also working on a native Affinity Publisher reader, as we call them. It's already in alpha on the MarkzPortal, where you can see where we're going with getting Affinity Publisher files directly in InDesign or Canva. You see Affinity Publisher InDesign, so people are comparing the three. You see just InDesign, so Affinity users are looking 2024 to present, just to get look at that. Look at Canva. It came on the scene, you know, back here, you see it was much different, and then it just took off. Just absolutely amazing. We're coming out very soon. It's now in pre-release. We have over on canva.com. It's part of our MarkzPortal. It's linked to the MarkzPortal system, you know, SAT solution. And if you go to apps here, and if you search for DesignMarkz, you'll see it right here. That's our internal version. And you won't see that. You'll just see this one. Just click there. And then you can use it in an existing design or use it in a new design. And that will help you get all these various formats into Canva in this case. But we also help you with our other product, ConvertMarkz, to get content from Canva into InDesign or content from Canva into Affinity Publisher, et cetera, et cetera. So this is really neat. Check it out, DesignMarkz over on canva.com. And like I mentioned, this is all part of our MarkzPortal, which we actually started because of Canva, because you need to have a portal to make add-ons into Canva. So this whole portal has started because of that. And this will allow you to drop various design files onto it, get a preview of your file, and then down here you get export options going, you know, InDesign to Quark or InDesign to Affinity Publisher, very popular right now, et cetera, et cetera. So check it out today, markzpearl.markzware.com. I was just blown away when I did this search recently. I've done this, you know, a few years back, but to see Canva, how they exploded onto the market is just incredible. It's amazing when you remove it, what you see in design. And, you know, it's amazing to see how Microsoft Publisher and QuarkXPress were right up there with InDesign, you know, in 2004. So 20 years ago, they're right up there. And look at that. Microsoft Publisher and QuarkXPress went down at the same pace as InDesign went up. At a certain point, you see it really starting to tail off here. And these also tailed off. So I'm curious if you add back, well, you know what happens when you add in Canva. That was right around 2018. And that's when you really start seeing InDesign go down. Isn't that interesting, right? and it's sort of stabilized here, had a little boost up in the pandemic time, and now it's sort of just stable. But when you add back in Canva, yeah, it's just so clear. 2018, you could say 2019 was just, you know, rocket ship ignited and off to the races. And what's amazing is Canva's not done yet. They have big plans and they have a lot more coming. So as does Affinity with this 30 October big announcement, the data proves it. The DTP landscape is changing and changing fast, but the pattern has been relatively slow. You can see it in the trends chart we just looked at. There's no doubt about it. Canva has had a massive effect on the design and DTP market. We're seeing with our MarkzPortal, our stats are showing more and more Canva PDFs coming in to be converted to InDesign. And that's because Canva users at a certain point need to hand it off to a professional designer. And that's one way to do it via our Convert Marks or via MarkzPortal natively just with the Canva PDF. The new trend we're seeing is people wanting to get stuff into Canva from professional design applications, particularly when you see Microsoft Publisher is being discontinued. All those files are going to be lost, unusable. They're going to completely remove Microsoft Publisher from the 360 suite from Microsoft. You won't even be able to get it anymore. You won't even be able to open your files because it's a proprietary file format. But we'll open all those disparate file types right in MarkzPortal and allow you to free it up to whatever you like. Even the JSON, structured JSON files with all your DTP layouts. The market is changing. It's just the way it is. You could say finally online tools are really viable, which, you know, back in 1997, 98, it was the big talk, you know, and we even had our flight check online back then, which is just way too early. But now this stuff is finally coming to fruition here. And MarkzPortal will also have preflighting in the future as well. So sign up today over on MarkzPortal.MarkzWare.com. Check it out. It already has some free preflighting in there, but it's going to get much more robust. We're going to allow you to go on the desktop of your customers and check stuff before it comes in. We're going to allow you to convert file formats and interchange between whatever you like. That's our goal. Many other file formats coming soon. So check it out today. Once again, thank you for the time. David from Markzware, wishing you a great day. Take care.